Hey there guys, today I'm going to be taking a quick dive into the dumpster fire that is the Creality Filament Dry Box. I'm going to be looking at some specs, pros, cons, and who I think this is for. So stick around and let's get into it. Okay guys, so the thing is, if you are going to be doing any kind of printing aside from PLA, you're probably going to want to have some way of drying your filament. I generally tend to print a lot in TPU and PETG, carbon fiber PETG. A lot of people use their home oven to dry their filament, but if I did that, my wife would probably slap me upside the head with a frying pan. So I opted to get a filament dry box, and the one I decided to get was from Creality. The reason that I decided to go with Creality is because I've had some really good experience with Creality as a company. I mean, the Sonic Pad and the Ender 3S1 Pro are perfect. They work awesome. So I figured, well, what the hell could go wrong with getting a filament dry box from Creality? Boy, was I wrong. I mean, the specs seem decent. It's supposed to go up to 50 degrees. According to the specs online, it has four different modes. 2 hours, 4 hours, 8 hours, and off. The thing is that I figured Creality makes good stuff, you know? Let's get into the pros. Pros are, it turns on. It has four modes, 2 hours, 4 hours, 8 hours, and off. And it heats up, doesn't get to 50 degrees, but it gets to about 45 degrees, and that's if the filament box closes. Okay, now for the cons. Where do I start? Okay, so this is where I need to expand a little bit. Let's start off, first of all, with the fact that not all filament spools, but about almost half of the filament spools from a myriad of different companies, I tried drying in the Creality dry box and they just didn't fit. What do I mean by that? Essentially, the circumference of the spool was too tall, so the lid didn't close properly. And the 45 degrees that I sometimes was able to manage to get of heat with this dry box, the vast majority of that heat just dissipated through that crack, right? Because I mean, if the thing doesn't close properly, that defeats a lot of the purpose. Now, I'm not saying that that was what happened with all of them. There's a lot of filament spools that really did fit in there properly. Everything was fine. Creality filament spools fit in there just fine. A couple of other ones, but you know, there was a few that really that weren't able to fit in there. I think that that's something that Creality could have definitely done better. I mean, just make it a little bit bigger, you know? The second con is that this dry box only has one heat setting on, right? So essentially you're supposed to be able to deal with the 50 degrees Celsius, which is 122 Fahrenheit. There's no option to change the temperature at all, which brings me to my third con. The timer only has four settings, 2 hours, 4 hours, 8 hours, and off. And the way they designed it is not really that great in my personal opinion either. Okay, so there's this little spinning wheel, this little dial over here, okay? And this thing, when you turn it, you see I'm turning it, it took five clicks to turn on. Isn't that great? Right? And basically, here, look at that. It takes a whole bunch of clicks. Now, the dial feels very tactile. That I can say. I mean, I feel these little satisfying clicks when I'm spinning it around. But aside from that, this thing is a little ridiculous. Okay, there, it's off. You turn it on and you have these little, so it's got a little fan in there. It's got a little fan inside, okay? And these little spinner wheels at the bottom, which is okay, I guess. But I mean, you know, it doesn't even really close properly. I mean, you know, you spend 50 bucks on a product like this, you know, and you expect that you're gonna be able to dry your filament at least, right? Okay, so who do I think that this product is for? Truth be told, I think that there's a lot of better options out there to spend your hard-earned cash than this thing. Truthfully, I would love Creality to come up with a better option, a better improved version 2.0. Creality, if you're listening, which I'm sure you're probably not because I'm a little itty bitty tiny eatsy beatsy channel, but still, if you're listening, come out with a better version. I mean, guys, you can do so much better than this, man. I mean, you got to come out with a version that has a larger internal volume, temperature control, and a different user interface, right? I mean, what's the deal with that little dial? I mean, you know, you put a little dial on a filament dryer, people are gonna assume that that's for turning up the heat. I mean, what? Guys, come on. I mean, I've been so happy with Creality's products, you know? I mean, the Ender 3, the Sonic Pad, the filament. I mean, guys, Creality makes excellent products, but this one is a bit of a dumpster fire. Gotta be honest. If you guys wanna hear something positive on Creality, check out my video up here. Anyway, if you guys got any value out of this video, I truly appreciate a subscribe because I'm really intent on putting out more content from now on. I really wanna grow this channel and I wanna grow the community with you, you know? And I'd love to have your input. Maybe you guys can help me grow and produce better content for you. Truth be told, man, I would have really loved to see Creality come out with a bit better option. I mean, you know, they have some pretty heavy hitters out there in this particular field. I mean, they make really quality, really quality stuff, and it really bums me out that I didn't do the research that I should have been doing, or maybe I just had a little picky. Maybe I'm a little picky. Maybe that's the problem. But you know what? Truth be told, I cannot in good conscience, based on my personal experience with it, recommend this product for pretty much anyone. Creality, if you, for some strange reason, are listening to a tiny little YouTuber, guys, come out with a better version. I mean, there's some really minor tweaks that you gotta fix here. That you guys are known for making really quality stuff and good products and relatively reasonable prices. You know, you gotta pick up your game, man. Anyway, guys, that's about it for now, all right? So I hope you subscribe, maybe tune in a little bit later. I'm already working on another video. I hope that you have a wonderful day. Take care. All right, bye-bye.